today's compost or your PDF. Boris, please.
While addressing the country at the 37th NRM Liberation Day celebrations in Kakumiro District, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni noted that Uganda is in the second financial year of a lower middle income status after attaining the World Bank's income threshold of $1,046 GDP per capita in 2021-2022 financial years.
Now, some people talk about Uganda as if Uganda started with the British. I really feel offended when I hear people talking like that. We have been here since time immemorial. And we have been here with all sorts of governments.
However, the World Bank has been disputing the claim on grounds that the Uganda Bureau of Statistics used the wrong tool of GDP as a measure of the size of its economy instead of gross national income used by the World Bank. But the president insisted that Uganda's economy is remaining with only 1 year to seal a permanent seat in the lower middle income status.
Unindi yankura akurana. Uino kuri ebiokuria. Ebiokuria. Nubitungo miringwe vili. Nolima ebiokuria. Ninga nubo inesente nubigura.
Museveni highlighted 5 points to spur the development of the country. These include being clear about development, socio-economic transformation, stamping out corruption, stamping out sectarianism, and protecting the environment and wealth creation.
And also ensure mass education, so that the whole society embraces a science-led society and get out of ignorance and superstition.
The president lauded anti-corruption agencies for taking a tough stance on corrupt government officials who stole the parish development model funds and tasked the district internal security officers, DISOs, RDCs, and police to step up their vigilance.
The DSOs and the CIDs should also be on notice. How does such corruption go on in your area of responsibility? And you do not know, or if you know, you do not report.
Museveni also lauded the NRM government for fostering unity in the country.
Tugende omukusaba.
He reiterated that defending sectarianism enabled the country to build strong national institutions like the army, judiciary, and political parties, which have guaranteed peace.
The riverbanks, the lake shores, the hilltops, etc., are crucial for our survival. We need water and clean air.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.